Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I'm gonna head back to the profane capital in just a minute, but first, I just want to talk about a couple things I did. One thing I did is I researched some of the rings that I wasn't too sure about what they did. Especially the reversal ring, the one that makes males perform female actions and vice versa. So it turns out what that actually does is it's a purely visual change. Apparently there is actually a change between female and male characters. Their animations are slightly different. But very, very slightly different. It's hard to notice. I didn't notice it when I switched, when I used this ring and took all my clothes off and moved around. I couldn't even tell. But yeah, it makes the animations a little bit different. And that's it. So I get the impression it's kind of more of a ring for lore than it is for actually any sort of a practical effect. I also looked at this one, Aldrich's Ruby, recovers HP from critical attacks. If you remember before, I wasn't quite sure what constituted a critical attack. It turns out that a critical attack is either a backstab, a riposte, or a guard break. And those are things I pretty much never do. I'm not entirely sure what a guard break is. I think it's when you, like, overwhelm them so they put their shield down or something. I'm not sure. And the riposte is obviously something that I can't do without a shield or some sort of a riposting weapon. So, yeah, that really wouldn't be very useful. And the other thing I did is going to be a very big change. I'm actually going to switch weapons. If you remember, I was talking about how I was pretty unsatisfied with how often I've been able to upgrade the spear. It's been, like, friggin' forever since I've upgraded it to +2. And also I've been annoyed with the fact that I can't use any sort of I'm not sure what they're called, I guess a buff? I can't use any sort of a damage buff. You know, these things? These bundles? Applies fire, applies lightning. I can't use any of those on it, I'm assuming because it's a soul transposed weapon. So between those two things, I was thinking of switching to a different weapon that wasn't soul transposed and seeing, given how much titanite I've got, seeing how high up I could get it and seeing whether it'd be better. So I went ahead and did that. I took my good old sharp S-Doc, which was at, I think it was at +2 before? Is that +2 or +3? And I upgraded it all the way to +6, which is as far as I can go at the moment. And I compared the stats, and guess what? It actually seems like it's better. So if you look at the stats, the base damage is almost exactly the same. It does one less base damage, but when you add up the extra damage it gets from the scaling with dexterity, it actually does significantly more damage. And that's because it scales with a rating of B instead of a rating of C. It scales better because I used the sharp gem on the S-Doc, which is what turned it from an S-Doc into a sharp S-Doc and made it scale better with dexterity. So yeah, it actually does do more damage. It weighs less, which doesn't really matter that much, but hey, it's something. And I can use pine bundles and stuff like that on it. So two big advantages, it does a bit more damage and I can use buffs on it. The disadvantages is that it doesn't have any sort of a poison effect. Although I don't think that's much of a disadvantage because I was thinking back to how often the poison effect ever actually got activated on enemies I was attacking. And the truth is, I've been using that spear for a long time, and that poison effect almost never procs. Like, almost never. So I don't think that's a big loss. The only other thing that I'm losing with it is the spear also has the effect of, after I defeat an opponent, it restores HP. And I looked at exactly how much it restores. It restores 30 HP with each defeated enemy. And given that I have almost 1,000 HP, restoring 30 per enemy is not really that big of a deal. So overall, I feel like the S-Dog is probably better for me. But who knows, you know? Once I find my last piece that I need to get Arstor's spear up to +3, maybe that'll be better then. We'll see. And by the way, just a kind of FYI, soul transposed weapons and normal weapons, they don't upgrade to the same level. Soul transposed weapons can only be upgraded to a max of +5. And normal weapons, like the S-Doc, can be upgraded to a max of +10. So with that in mind, the fact that it's +2 isn't quite as bad as it seems. It's kind of more like, if you converted it to the scale of the S-Doc, where this can go to 10, this can go to 5, then this +2 is actually more like a +4. So it's actually not, like, super, super low level, this beer. But it still is definitely falling behind. I guess one other sort of bad thing is I'm gonna have to relearn how to use this freaking thing. I did use it quite a bit, so it's probably not gonna be too bad. I think probably the biggest change I'm gonna have to get used to is, of course, the range. If I remember right, I think the S-Dock has a little bit of a longer range. And the other major change is if I roll and then attack, it does a stabbing motion. Whereas I remember when I first switched over to Arstor's Spear, the big difference is that when you roll an attack with that, it does, like, uppercut, which has much less range. So I'm gonna have to get used to that. Alright, back to the profaned capital. Also, this weapon is definitely going to do different damage against enemies, not just because its damage is different, but because the type of weapon is actually different. Arstor's Spear is, of course, a spear. I can't remember if the name of the weapon has any effect of the on the damage, or if it's just the type. You know how this one says thrust and this one says standard slash thrust? I think it's that has the effect on, like, that's what determines the damage type, I think. So yeah, this one's standard slash thrust, this one's just thrust, so it might be a little bit different. Probably be better against certain things and worse against other things. Look at that texture change. Is it gonna pop back? No, there we go. Look at that. Seamless, just... Whoop. Beautiful. Alright, got another gargoyle to fight. Seriously? An inanimate object is trying to kill me? Alright, I'm not gonna fight you on this bridge. Let's go fight over here. Are you coming? I think I could probably... Yeah, I can just kind of fall off the edge there, I think, and travel down there. But let's see what's over in here. Whoa. Oh my god. Look at all these riches. Is this a dragon's lair? Also, look at all these bodies. Got a bad feeling about this. These bodies look all toasted. Thank you. That wasn't too bad. Oh, hey. Either I've gotten better, or this weapon is a lot better, or maybe it's just much better against gargoyles, because, man, it's making short work of those gargoyles. Oh, okay, this leads around there. Ooh, boss. I wonder if this thing won't spit fire at me anymore now that they're gone. Perhaps I were controlling it. Can only hope. Those gargoyles might come to life. Very, very good chance they might. No. Color me surprised. Which is some sort of a beige, I think. Uh-oh. It's gonna be a lot of fire. Maybe I can lure them out. Okay, it's a trap. Alright, got it out of the way. Weapon required ahead. Well, no shit. Weapons required always ahead. Try dashing through. Ah, I'm not going there yet anyway. Thank you. Yeah, it's real. Neither of those are real. Oh my god, I'm almost dead. Great shield. A great shield adorned with flowing patterns, a celebration of an ancient glory. Boasts the highest stability of such shields, but with reduced stamina regeneration speed. Perhaps it is glory that begets indolence. Jesus Christ. That is huge. It's like a big piece of steel. Beautiful shield, though. I think that's it for this place. I think the boss is next. Oh no, not quite yet. There's an item up there. Ah, you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna get the item because I am inevitably gonna die to this boss, so I'll get it on the way back. Oh right, it said try dashing through. Like, try dashing through here? Time for friendship. Visions of sadness. Visions of weapon. What? I don't understand. That is a big weapon. I'm sorry, I swear I'm not here to steal your booty. Wow, you have a lot of hit points. What the hell? How am I ever gonna kill you? Something happens in this fight to make it easier, right? Otherwise, I think my weapon might literally break before I defeat it. god, the Gargi's back. No. Let's get this real quick. Try going to the back of the chamber, see if there's, I don't know, something back there. I see an item. Yeah, that's a weapon. That's definitely a weapon. Only a storm? Silence. It's gonna take 2 million years. Wait, the pillars. Is there something with the pillars? Do I need to make them destroy the pillars? Let's try. Didn't do anything. Damage to me. Get it. There's just like no way I can finish this fight. This is going to take literally an hour. I must be missing something. see if this does more damage. No, this is like exactly the same. That does more damage, like, it's definitely got a weakness on its arm or something, but it's not like I can reliably hit the arm. I must be missing something. Do I need to use that weapon I just picked up against it? Like, let's take a look at that. Was this, right? Yeah. It's a great sword. Weighs more, of course, does a very good amount of damage. Wait. Am I reading that right? It has no attribute requirements? What? Greatsword with a broken blade, also known as the Giant Slayer, for the residual strength of storm that brings giants to their knees. Oh, I am supposed to use that weapon. Yhorm the Giant once held two of these, but gave one to the humans who doubted him, and left the other to a dear friend before facing his fate as a Lord of Cinder. Aww. Skill as Storm King. Assume stance to imbue sword with storm, most effective when facing giants. Okay, so I'm definitely going to want to do that. That is sad. I'm going to have to use his own weapon against him. And that explains why it has no stat requirements, because that guarantees that everybody can use it, because you pretty much have to use it to defeat it. I wonder if it's worth upgrading it. Wait a minute. That's a greatsword? That's the tiniest greatsword I've ever seen. I mean, I know it's broken, but still. Ooh. I slow roll with it. Shit. I am slightly overweight. And if I get rid of my torch, I'm 0.1% overweight. Dang. Alright, let's go pop some souls and level up then. See, what do I have? Fading souls are terrible. $10,000? What do I need? Probably like $20,000 or so.
Well, speak, then talk.
$23,000.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Let's just use all of the fading souls. Oh wow, that was just sad. There we go.
Well, very then taken.
There we go. Normal roll. Also, let's see if we can upgrade it. And we can. Right? Yeah, uses... Wait a minute. Uses Titanite Scale. Hold on. scale. Oh no, I don't want to use that. That's the same thing I need for Arstor's spear. No thanks.
Pretty beacon.
Alright, let's get a feel for the moveset of this weapon. So, fast attacks. It's definitely a very slow weapon. Strong attack. Oh yeah, destroy that barrel. Gonna take down that giant in no time. And then special ability. Whoa. Oh, the effect stays on it. That is an incredibly cool effect. I wonder how long it stays on there for. Whoa! Okay, now here's my question. Let me read the description for it again. Assume stance to imbue Sword of Storm, most effective when facing giants. Well, it doesn't really answer my question. My question is, once the effect is on it, it looks like, yeah, you gotta keep it there until it like bursts again and then it stays on the weapon. At this point, does that mean it's doing bonus damage to the giant? Because I could either just keep attacking with it like this, or I could go back into that stance and then do an attack, and it does that. Which I'm sure would do shit tons of damage, but also that makes the effect go away, which means I'm gonna have to charge it up again. So I wonder what's better, just charging it up and doing normal attacks, or doing those special attacks? I guess I'll just have to mess around with it. And if I do want to keep doing those special attacks, then I might need to reallocate my potions and get some FP potions. It seems like such an epic fight now with that constant storm on my sword. It's really such a cool effect. Okay, yeah, that did not do much damage. So I think I need to use it as a special ability. I'm gonna need some FP potions. Unless, wait, did that not use any FP? I still got my FP. Balls! And yeah, It's actually not using any FP. I guess they give you like a... just to make sure you can do the fight and not have to worry about FP, I guess? I don't know. Just happened. Was that the last Fire Lord I needed? It's obviously not the end of the game. But yeah, I kind of forgot I was even trying to get all the Fire Lords. Guess that was the last. Who are you? Where the hell am I? Also, I just want to say that that was an interesting fight. It was incredibly easy, like, it really was not that challenging at all. But at the same time, it was also one of the coolest fights, because of the whole thing where you can't really fight it with a normal weapon, you need to use this broken giant slaying weapon, which has all that lore attached to it, use its own weapon against itself. And the effect on the weapon was also just beautiful, and I don't know, it was one of the easiest boss fights, but also one of the coolest and saddest.
Prince Lothric is in your hands. Please save his soul. Tell him what he must be, a lord.
Basin vows. It's a key. Place basin at a statue of a beheading knight. Chalice used in old ceremony in which Lothric knights take their vows. It is only a formality now, but it remains as an empty practice. Place this basin at the statue of a beheading knight. That'd be this one, right? Yeah. Uh-oh. I didn't even get a chance to get my potions back or anything. Welp, I'm dead. It's beautiful! Oh my god, look at his movements. That's bad. I thought I would have had the option to place it. Like, what if I didn't want to place it? Do I still have it? How do I get back there? Where was that? I know I've been there before, but I don't remember. Nah, I've still got it. Hold on. Let's go back to Yhorm the Giant's place. Yeah, so there's nothing more I can do in here, right? Nope. Ew, those bodies make squishy noises. I really don't remember where that place is. I know it was back a ways. Cathedral of the Deep? No. I don't remember at all. What if we go back to the Firelink Shrine? Is there anything different there? Did I defeat all the Fire Lords? Like, I'm not really sure. It always happens with Dark Souls games where I lose track of, like, what I'm actually supposed to be doing in the big picture. Yeah, nothing seems different here. Alright, let me try to find this place. I'll be right back. Okay, so based on what I read, I think it's around here. This is Vort of the Boreal Valley. If you remember, I went over here and got lifted off by those creepy creatures. I think it's back this way. I think I've got to run there. I think it's all the way at the top up here. Ow! Yep, there we go. What the fuck? Uh-oh, it's got two swords now. Whoa! Oh, how did I dodge those? So beautiful, it's making my performance terrible. It's getting harder to predict its moves. Oh god. No! I was doing so well. Yeah, such a gorgeous boss. It moves like it's underwater. Until it goes to attack, and then it's much, much faster. Yeah, my performance really does consistently go to garbage as soon as it pulls out the second weapon. Goes from like 60 to 30 FPS. Alright, well, in case this episode... Just to make sure this episode doesn't end up being super long, I'm gonna give this one more attempt. I've already defeated one boss this episode. I feel pretty good about that. One more attempt. That was terrible. I can't end on that note, come on. Oh, no. I think I'll live. Yeah. Whew. Gotta have almost max health to live. That's a new one. That's also a new one. Those delayed attacks, they're so hard. So hard to time them. Okay, well, I know I can take this boss. It's not super hard. I can definitely take it, and I want to keep trying, but this episode might end up being like an hour and a half, so I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to go defeat it.